Addressing the climate change crisis is the most challenging and consequential problem that humanity has ever faced.
The past 6 years have been the warmest on the planet.
Our track record on climate change mitigation is drastically short of what it needs to be, and time is running out.
The planet has given us a deadline, and that deadline is very soon.
There is no question that we are at a point where we have to make significant progress towards clean energy, towards renewable energy, and we can't do it alone.
The mission of the Future Energy Systems Center is to bring science, innovation, and policy to help us accelerate the energy transition.
The Future Energy Systems Center is part of MIT's most recent climate plan. We're looking at all the pieces. How do things fit together? What are the economics? What are policies?
The center is actually bringing together faculty and researchers from different areas of the Institute who have different brands of expertise or different spheres of knowledge, and saying we need to actually come together in a collaborative way to bring what we know to the table and help us to take this broader view that really is essential for being able to usher in the kinds of transformation that we need.
Our member companies for the Future Energy Systems Center include utilities, energy, automotive, technology, materials. We're going beyond the question of, well, what's the next battery technology? This is a holistic analysis that considers all the interplays between how do we produce energy, how do we use energy, how do we move energy around? Where is the best fit for one type of energy versus another?
The center is designed to help members go deep, think through with us what the implications of the seismic shift in their particular industry and geographical neighborhoods will look like.
The modeling capabilities that have been developed by our researchers allow us to look at the entire system, soup to nuts.
The Future Energy Systems Center has a portfolio of more than 20 different projects across six key areas, which include electric power, transportation, industry, energy storage and low carbon fuels, buildings, and carbon management.
Remaking the electric grid to accommodate these new sources of power is a massive technology, system, and policy problem. And it's one of the major areas of focus in the center.
We deploy at commercial scale today large amounts of solar and wind generation. But how do we deploy that most effectively? How do we understand where do you get the greatest carbon emissions reduction?
Energy storage and batteries for electric vehicles. How can we take this relatively successful example of a technology development and scaling and extend that to the myriad technologies that need to be a part of our energy portfolio?
I actually work in the area of biofuels or biological transformations. How much biomass is there really? How much is it in different parts of the world? How much of it is accessible for different purposes and for different end uses? And so one of the projects that the center is looking at is trying to take the systems view to really ask the question, what do we have access to?
In the Future Energy Systems Center, what really excites me is the ability to start and maintain some really valuable dialogues where there is a tolerance of creativity and out-of-the-box thinking, but also that might get challenged. And we might go through several iterations as we get feedback from folks who see things and think about things at different scales.
There's no one roadmap on how to get there. And companies are working with us to shed a light on these different uncertainties and what the potential pathways look like and where they can fit in and make a big contribution.
Any carbon emissions we can reduce, everything we can do to get emissions out of the system as soon as possible makes life for our children and their children better in the future.
This is really a massive problem, and it is very easy to put our heads in the sand and say it's such a big problem that we can't solve it. The more people we have coming to the table, the better understanding we'll have of both what our critical issues are, as well as what the potential is to deploy solutions in a way that has maximum benefit for everybody on the planet.
It's the best way to get involved with a very large number of faculty working on all kinds of problems from energy production to energy use to energy policy, the social science of energy, the economics of energy, and gain exposure to their work in all of those areas. Collectively, they also become part of a group of companies that are working on something that's very important socially and globally to all of human society. And it helps propel collectively our effort toward a decarbonized, safer world.